This is Belle with Belle Can Cook. Thank you for coming in with me another day. I am getting over like a little funk, so that's the reason why my voice sounds the way that it does. However, I'm not sick. So I think it's just the change in the weather here. But please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And today I'm going to be making one of my family's favorites. So today I'm going to be making a brown butter and walnut chocolate chip cookie. And it's gonna be fire, y'all. I promise. So stick on in there with me. That way you can see me go through the steps and getting this taken care of. And hopefully you'll like it enough to make it for your own family. All right, you guys. And just one other note, I just want to say thank you so much for all of your support and all your love to all of my subscribers, friends, and family, and everybody that takes a little bit of time out to add me to their day. I'm eternally thankful, grateful, and very blessed. And all right, let's get started. Today, let me kind of show you what my ingredients are. We have flour. This is about 3 cups. Yeah, this is about 3 cups of flour. And I'm gonna be making a pretty large batch because what my son doesn't know is I'm sending him some home. So when he leaves so yeah, I'm gonna miss my baby, but yeah, I'm gonna send him some home too. So that's why I'm making a pretty big batch for him and for home. And along with that, along with the flour, I will be making, well, including 1.5 cups of white sugar. This is like the organic white sugar, so it's more of a larger crystal, and it's a little bit on the brown side. And I also am including 1 cup of brown sugar, dark brown. To this, I will be adding I think I'm gonna add a little bit more than this. I'm gonna be adding a total of 3 sticks of butter. Yeah, I said it, 3 sticks of butter. And that's what I'm gonna use to brown my butter. I have 1 egg, 1 whole egg, shall I say. And then 1 yolk. That's just the yolk. Baking soda. Baking powder. Chocolate chips. Now that these chips, guys, is just 2 different types of chips. They're both dark chocolate chips. And the reason why I use dark chocolate chips is because for me, it adds a depth of flavor and richness to your cookie. So I really like working with dark chocolate chips whenever I make chocolate chip cookies. And these particular chips is two different types. Y'all can see that. So I have a Toll House and a Hershey's Dark. And the Hershey's Dark is a smaller chip. Yeah, so this is about a total of, I think I use like 1.5 cups of the chips. And walnuts. This particular bag of walnuts I got at the food pantry. And y'all, let me just tell you, just to kind of give you a brief understanding of just how important food pantries are. So I go to the food pantry. I'm not ashamed of that. And I'm very grateful and thankful, you know, that we have food pantries here anytime that, you know, there are needs for the family. And I also want to say that when I go to the food pantry, I also help other families as well, because no blessing is mine alone. Any blessing that the Most High gives me, I have to pass it on to somebody else. That's just how it is. And so yeah, I got these walnuts through the food pantry, and they're big. It was a big bag. This is actually full to the top. As you can see that, you know, walnuts are popular here. So We've eaten a lot of the walnuts, and then I'm going to use about maybe a half a cup of walnuts, maybe a little bit more than a half a cup, and I'm going to chop these up really, really good and add those to the cookies as well. So, all right, and then I have my vanilla extract and my salt. I think that's it, y'all. So, stay tuned. And again, remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. All right, be right back. So what I'm about to do first is I'm gonna chop up some of my walnuts. So again, I'm just kind of eyeball about how many that I want. And I was saying about a little bit more than half a cup, right? So that's about the amount of walnuts I'm going to be working with in my recipe. All right. So what I'm going to do, you know, just a nice break of the cookies. I'm all right, of the walnuts. Okay, so I'm just gonna do a rough chop also. You don't want the cookie to overpower everything, unless that's your thing, because and that's totally okay too. Okay, so that's a pretty good rough chop of all of the nuts. There we go. Okay. See that? So now we're just gonna add these to our bowl over here. Look, I'm getting messy. Towel and wipe up everything else. Okay, so now we have our walnuts also. So yeah, it's still about maybe just a little over a half a cup. Yeah. Sifting my flour, and the purpose for me of sifting the flour is to make sure that you have a really well-balanced cookie. Sifting the flour, make sure that your everything, all of your ingredients are incorporated really well, that enough air gets to the batter, and you just have a much better, much, you know, crumblier cookie. So again, this is about the 3 cups of flour. And I'm gonna add all of my dry ingredients, and then I'll show you how I'm going to incorporate my wet ingredients. And then before I finish sifting this, in the middle process of the sifting, I then add my baking soda and my baking powder. And then my salt, I add that at the end. Oops. Okay. Well, that is well sifted, y'all. And then again, I add my salt at the end. and that just helps for me. And I use about a half a teaspoon, and it's not a lot, because what I usually do is make sure that my recipes are pretty well balanced, the flavor of them. So yes, I use a whole half a teaspoon of salt, because salt is the great equalizer when you are cooking baked goods. Okay, so I have my baking soda, baking powder, flour, salt, all combined. And then to that, let me get spatula, kind of stir everything up. And to this, I'm going to add my chocolate chips. And you add your chocolate chips. In my opinion, it helps to make sure that the chips get spread evenly. And it helps to make sure that your chips are spread evenly. Okay, so we're gonna set that to the side. In the meantime, with my pot, I've been heating my pot, and now it's got a really nice heat on it, and this is where I'm going to start cooking browning my butter. So I hope everybody's having a fantastic day. Well, it's like nighttime now, so a fantastic evening. Okay, I'm gonna add this, yes, the entire thing. And you'll understand why after you are done making your cookies. That flavor will be so amazing. And you'll make them like this every time. Now, you can certainly cut back on this recipe. So I was going to say, if you're just wanting to make half this recipe, because again, I'm placing 3 sticks in here because I'm making enough for home and for my baby. So, you can definitely half this recipe and have a stick and a half of butter instead of 3 whole sticks when you are creating your own. So, okay, so I'm just going to cut my fire down a little bit because it's important not to burn your butter, and just to make sure that you are cooking it evenly enough and giving it the opportunity to do what it needs to do. There we go. All right, guys, so see it's starting to boil. And another important tip, like when you're browning your butter, I always use a wooden spoon. And the reason for that is just to make sure that with a metal spoon, it heats up a lot. You can also use a Teflon spoon if you choose, but I always like to use a good wooden spoon, and it doesn't scratch the pot either. And it doesn't get hot. So there we go. So I'm just gonna let this sit here, and I'm going to let this cook. I'm gonna come back to this in like 5 minutes. I have my fire down on 2, and it's just kind of doing its thing. And then I'm going to come back periodically and check on it and definitely stir it, because that's another important constant when you're making or browning butter, that you want to continue to stir it as you're going through the process. Okay. All right. So stick on in there with me. I'll be back in just a few minutes. All right, everybody. So I have just completed browning my butter. I want to give you a peek as to what that looks like. And what I also add to that after I've browned it. Yeah, baby. That's another extra. And yes, it does do that, and it's perfectly fine. It just adds a depth of flavor to your butter and to your cookies. Okay, so now I'm going to pour this into a glass dish or a glass. My brown butter is done, and now I am going to let that cool. So now what I'm going to do is take my sugar, and I've added some of the whey that I scooped off of my butter, I placed into my sugar. So what I'm about to do in this particular part of the recipe is I'm going to add my eggs to my sugar. I'm going to stir it in. I'm going to add my other egg, my yolk. So what I'm going to do is wait for my butter to cool down. Oh, and I forgot, I'm going to add my walnuts into my flour mixture also. So my walnuts and my chocolate, we're all in there together, co-mingling. It's actually a really simple, really easy recipe. Oops. Shoot. I hate when I do that. Oh, well. All right. I'll be back when it's time to add all of these beautiful and luscious ingredients together. All right, stay tuned. Mind, this is my dry. This is my sugar and my eggs. This is my cold butter. It's my brown butter and my vanilla extract. So what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna add my sugar and my eggs to my flour mixture. Actually, I meant to take this out. Shoot. It ain't gonna hurt nothing. I got all my butter off. Got that over there. And then I'm also going to pour a little bit of my butter. And I'm going to mix, baby. And I do this by hand. You have the option if you like. You can do this with the mixer. Totally your thing. That's fine. Oops. Jacket is getting caught up in it. I need to add a little bit more liquid. And that's because it's actually just kind of tough. So I'm going to add everything else in here. And all of that delicious brown butter. And I want you to get all of that butter out of your. Yeah, now it's coming together. And then after you get everything mixed up together, you're going to cook your cookies on 325. For 10 minutes. See, look, it's a good thick batter too. It's not thin, it's not runny. Okay, y'all, see? It looks so good, y'all. The smell, oh my Lord. It smells incredible. So this is my chocolate chip brown butter chocolate chip with walnuts. Alright, so stay tuned. I'll come back and I'll show you what these beautiful babies look like after they've been cooked. And now, you also have the option of placing these in the refrigerator if you like, and letting your batter, you know, sit for a minute before you start cooking them. Totally okay, either way. But I'm making these now because I'm going to be sending them with my son. So, yeah. All right, stay tuned. All right, so after they are done, I will come back and I will show you what they look like. All right, peace. Okay, guys, so right now I'm about to, this is a very large cookie sheet. And I'm going to spoon out my cookies. So I have like a medium size cookie scooper. I'm definitely gonna give me a bigger one because I would rather have a bigger scoop when I'm scooping this dough out. So I kind of overdo it on purpose because I want these to be, you know, thicker, bigger cookies. And give them their space. And I have my parchment paper down. Parchment paper just makes sure everything cooks, you know, without burning. And it helps to make sure that everything cooks at a more even temperature. Now this is a little crumbly. There's nothing wrong with that. I just didn't want like a really wet batter. All right, I'll let you know what they look like as soon as I take them out the oven, guys. Stay tuned. Ooh-wee, y'all. Look at that. These are my cookies that I just took out the oven. Now, I'm going to tell y'all something, what I did. So, because these are so big, 10 minutes isn't enough. You actually need more like 15, maybe a little bit longer. But, y'all, these came out so beautiful. Look at that. Now, normally when they are smaller, when I make them smaller, then the 10 minutes is a good time. But these are much bigger, much bigger. Look at that. So, here you go. These are my brown butter chocolate chips with walnut cookies. And they look fantabulous, y'all. And I'm going to let these sit here and cool for a little bit. I'm going to let them sit and cool for a little bit. And I'm going to sample it after everything's cool. And I will be right back. Okay, y'all. I told you that I would come back to show you what the cookie looks like once it has cooled off. And here is the cookie. I've actually peeled it off my sheet because I put some in the container for my son and then the rest in the container for the house. Bon appetit. That don't even make no sense. How good that is. It's super buttery. I'm sorry. I took the camera off my face, y'all. I'm just like in heaven right now. That is so amazing. You got your walnuts through there. You got all those different chips. And it's flaky. Got a real good structure. Parchment paper cooks your bottoms evenly. All you need is a real cold glass of milk. If you're like me, I like ice cream in my cookies. I'll lay down a couple of them in a bowl, and then I get a nice scoop of vanilla ice cream, especially when they're warm right out the oven. Y'all. All right. This is Belle. Belle Can Cook. Signing off. Remember, be good to yourself and to others. And remember, you are all blessed. Take care. Blessings.